Cebuma de las Cruz is housed in a small chapel located near the Basilica Minor del Santo Niño on Magallanes Street. Magellan's Cross holds a very big part of the history of Cebu. It is believed to be a Christian cross planted by Portuguese and Spanish explorers headed by Ferdinand Magellan. It was planted upon their arrival in Cebu on March 15, 1521. That day also marked the birth of Christianity in the land. The original cross was believed by the people of old to have miraculous healing power, so they started chipping it away. Because of that, the government officials was prompted to supposedly encase it in another wooden cross made from Tindalo. The original cross was destroyed or disappeared after the death of Magellan. The Poblacion Watchtower or the Bantay Moros in Dalaget. Dalaget was a home to watchtowers. These watchtowers were the first line of the defense of the town against pirates and raiders. The Poblacion Watchtower, which is also called Bantay Moros, originally had two levels. It was the part of the network of watchtowers along the southern coast of Cebu and was built in 1768. Today, the watchtower is one of the landmarks of Dalaget. Aside from the watchtower in the Poblacion, a cannon was also stationed in the town to protect the town from pirates and raiders. It was the strongest weapon of the Spaniard against invaders.
Cristo Rey Monument. The Cristo Rey Monument in Dalaget was erected with the aim of uplifting the spiritual life of the residents of Dalaget. It was built in 1938 through the efforts of Father Roberto Sarmiento. It featured a balustered stairway along with a perimeter fence. The Cristo Rey Monument is located in the middle of the plaza in front of the church. San Guillermo de Aquitania Church. Dalaget was established after it became a Vista of Arcar. While it was established as an independent parish in 1711, the permanent church structure was only built in 1802. Construction of the San Guillermo de Aquitania Church was completed in 1825. A rectory was later added in 1832, while the belfry was completed in 1860. Aside from serving the religious needs of the residents of the town, the church provided protection for the people whenever raiders and pirates attacked the town. The church has an earthquake baroque design featuring buttresses along its sides. The facade is divided into three levels. A rococo design with gilded moldings characterizes the interior of the church, similar to the other Spanish-era structures. The San Guillermo de Aquitania Church is made of stone in the lower level, while wood dominates the upper level of the structure.
For a brief background, Leon got its name from one spot located along the coastline of this bustling town, north of the Queen City of the South, the Silot. The Silot is a place where the flows and ebbs of water coming from the bay creates a whirlpool. In Cebuano, this phenomenon is called Lilo. Due to this, the place was called Liloan, or a place where you can find the Lilo. The town of Liloan has a lot of things to offer to visitors and travelers who are just passing by on their way to the north. The Parola, or the lighthouse, is the reason why the town was given the nickname the Light of the North. The lighthouse is situated on an elevated area in Barangay Catarman, Liloan, overlooking the Mactan Channel. It was built during the American period under the executive order issued by the first American Governor General of the Philippines, William Howard Taft. It started providing guidance to ship passing into the channel on April 1, 1905 and has continued to do so for over 100 years. The Parola is managed by the Philippine Coast Guard and light point flashes at 5 seconds interval. Fort San Pedro. The fort was originally made of wood and built after the arrival of Spanish explorer Miguel Lopez de Legazpi. Lopez commanded the construction of the fort since he established himself the first governor of the Capitancy General of the Philippines. In the early 1600s, the wooden fort was replaced with stone to repel Muslim raiders. Then in 1738, adding more renovations to the fort, it finalized its look and still looks the same as today. It is the oldest triangular-shaped fort in the country. It serves as the nucleus of the first Spanish settlement in the Philippines. During the Philippine Revolution, on late 1890s, the fort was attacked and taken over by the Filipino revolutionaries, who used it as a stronghold. Then, in early 1940s, during World War II, the fort served as the fortification of Japanese soldiers.